This is Sway.
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 In the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
Shade 4-5.
Wake your punk ass up.
Sway in the morning, Shade 4-5. Had to be. I'm really excited right now, HB.
Tell him why, son.
Well, you know, man. You know, we do a lot of things in this game, HB. We don't just wake up and come do radio.
Nope.
Don't just do radio.
Let him know it's different and it's layers.
It's different
to
up
it.
In here, it's right?
Layers. To
layers.
It.
The pedigree. Levels to the pedigree
levels
up in here.
Levels to the pedigree. Your
right?
Daddy just ain't no scrub.
High caliber. This is the highest of the caliber that you could find, HB.
Got that strong sperm.
Got that.
What the fuck?
A daddy, the sperm. What are you talking about, Heather? You expecting?
Fuck with me or not, Tracy G.
I'm fucking with you.
Okay.
I made my decision.
That's it.
I made my decision.
Listen, man, one of my co-stars is here.
Oh, another one of them.
My co-stars is here. Y'all watched us on Empire.
That, you right.
You ain't watched me on Empire for a season or two, but you watched me on Empire.
I'll never forget it, Sway.
I made that shit hot. Thank you, Lee Daniels, for giving me the opportunity. I'll take it again anytime you want me to come back.
Hey. Whenever you're ready.
Whenever you're ready, right? But nah, up now, man. This young lady, I knew she had bars before she got on Empire.
Ooh.
I heard that Burn song from years ago on her SoundCloud. What else will we listen to? Bars. Bars, son. She got bars, son.
Bars.
Welcome to the show, ladies and gentlemen. The one and only Breezy is here.
Breezy,
what up?
What up?
I'm chilling.
How you doing?
I'm good.
Good to see you.
I'm happy to see you.
I'm happy to see you.
She got bomb energy, right?
She got bomb energy on that screen, too.
I appreciate it.
That's what's up. What's your name on the show?
Frida Gatz.
That's a hard-ass name. I was thinking, because I knew that wasn't your real name, but damn, that would be a good-ass name for a rapper, right?
Word.
What you think?
You think so?
Man, Gats?
I like it. I mean, it fits her.
It fits her, right?
It fits her, yeah.
Gats.
She a little Gat.
Yeah, well, you know, Gats, when I came up in Oakland, a Gat was a gun.
That's what she is. She a little gun.
She's a little gun.
Gat, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, she.
A Gatling. Go get the Gat, son.
Show me your gun. Show me your Gat.
I'll shoot from the side.
You
Heather, that's how you be swinging.
I'm do everything low roll.
Shoot from the side.
Yeah, be careful. Be careful, Breezy. That's the original Gat holder right there.
True life.
Heather Gats, and then she turned it to Heather B.
Heather B.
He just
I like Heather B better.
You like Heather B?
You know.
What are you doing?
History.
What are you trying to do to you?
He just tried to just tell you some stuff.
Okay.
We just have a conversation. You from Philly originally?
Yeah. I was born in Philadelphia. I was raised partially in Delaware. Mm-hmm. Wilmington,
uh-huh.
Delaware.
Okay.
So I've been in Tri-State my whole life.
Tri-State? Yeah. Listen to that voice. Is that a voice or a voice?
Is that a voice?
That's nice.
It's original. Like, a lot of times people, to me, I feel like people just try to sound like other people and they lose their voice in that. But you have the most power and use your tools. Use what you have. It may not, the more you get comfortable with it, the more powerful it becomes.
True life.
And I can honestly say, like, I'm just like, over the past couple years, I'm just getting comfortable with my voice.
Okay.
Because for a woman, it is pretty deep.
Yeah.
It's a little raspy. You know what I'm saying? So, it's not what your average girl's going to sound like. My mom might call. She might think I'm my brother. In the morning, I'm like, hello.
Really?
Hello.
Is she thinking your brother?
Yeah, she did sometimes.
Damn, that's crazy, huh? That's that's part of the tools, you know what I mean?
Right.
That's because, let's be honest, you know, a lot of female MCs sound alike. The tone of their voice.
You're right.
Mm-hmm. The cadence, right?
Mm-hmm. Right. And some of them sounds you can't tolerate.
You can't, right?
Some of them sounds you can't tolerate.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think when I listen to myself, I listen with a consumer ear.
Mm-hmm.
And I could tolerate my voice.
Yeah.
So I ain't mad at it.
You could tolerate your own
that's
voice.
That's good. So
I can't. I don't listen to mine.
You don't?
Nah,
you have a great voice. Look where you at. You have a great voice.
Thank you, Breezy. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
You know, I just, too much sugar ain't good for you. So I can't listen to myself every day.
You see where he go with it now? You see how he take
you
down that road?
Right.
Yeah, you know. Like, get diabetes.
What I was going to ask you, Bree, with you saying how, wow.
You know
that
what?
Just caught wind of my ear right there. Wow. But Bree, with you saying how you have a consumer ear as well, it's interesting because a lot of rappers will come up here and they only listen to their music when they're high. And I'll be thinking to myself, does that mean you're assuming that your audience is also on
high as in on drugs?
Exactly.
Nah, well, I don't partake. Okay. In any drug activity.
Look at
let that breathe for a second.
That's like an anomaly in this game.
You're the 1% of rappers who don't.
You're right. Because when I'm working, I like to be sober. I'm good. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I don't need anything because I'm pretty high on my own. So that's just a little too much.
Okay.
But everybody's not high when they're listening to music. I mean, some of that music you can hear and it's like, oh, this is stoner music. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, it sounds like you want to be in a daze mm-hmm. or in a trance, so to speak. You know what I'm saying? Right. So, I mean, for those who get high.
Then, right, you know? Exactly. No disrespect. So what's your vibe then in the studio? Like, are you someone that's like, all right, I need the vanilla scented candles over here?
I really just like, I like the lights low. You know what I'm saying? And I like to be by myself. Mm-hmm. I really do. I'm not the big entourage. You know, I don't care if you smoke or if you drink, but just you can't do it in here.
Ah.
You know what I'm saying?
Boundaries.
So, yeah. And that's because it's just, you know, it's too many distractions. I don't like that. You know, when people get to smoking and drinking, mm-hmm. they mm-hmm. start saying unnecessary things. Mm-hmm. And I'm one of them people that, you know, one wrong look at me is going to fuck my whole vibe up. Mm. So it's like, we got to just, you know, to save all of that. Just let me be by myself.
That's real.
Especially you know what I'm in the studio, because that's where you're most vulnerable. So
yeah, somebody... and I don't even want nobody next to me on a phone clicking, Snapchat. Mm. Don't mm-hmm. do that. Just
respect you know, the vibes.
And, well, it's a exactly. work environment. You
exactly.
know?
And that's people what don't people look at get it confused. Like it's a that. Job.
Right. It's a job.
It's a job. So, you know, and a lot of people come into play. I mean, because the rap is. It's not necessarily taken so seriously as it mm-hmm. used to be. Mm-hmm. Right. You know what I mean? Everybody's thinking they just go in the booth and get high and spit. Literally. You know yeah. what I'm saying? And it's like, it's not. It's a little more to it than that. You yeah. know what I'm saying? And I just happen to take it very seriously. So don't play. You know what I'm saying? This is my representation on the line. So I need to be able to work comfortably mm-hmm. and do what I need to do to make sure I develop the best product as I'm in the studio.
Hell yeah.
Sounds like an MC to me
Word,
over here.
Pretty much.
Sounds like an MC.
I mean, if you're going to do it, just do it right.
Yeah, that's what's up. How'd
do
you,
it well.
How'd you get your name?
My grandmother gave me that name. My mom, when I was born, there's in a, you know, delivery room and she couldn't figure out, well, her or my mother or the doctor could not figure out why I wouldn't stop hollering at the top of my lungs.
Okay.
And the minute that they shut the windows and the air couldn't come in, it was like, okay, she was cold.
So, hence, Bree?
Bree-Z.
That was genius right there.
I mean, that,
touch of irony in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's just, that's how it is. And that, you see where I'm at. I got a hoodie on and my mm-hmm. jacket and I'm always cold. Yeah. I don't know why.
You don't like that cold wind, right?
I don't.
Congratulations on all the success.
Thank you so much.
It must be a great feeling, man. To walk outside, people recognize you. And the thing that's interesting about you, I've seen a lot of artists on different type of shows, including reality shows. And once they do those shows, the careers as artists.
Tizank.
Yeah, they plummet.
Yeah.
For you, it's different, though, because the moment you came on that show, whether people knew it or not, you can tell you were MC, that right. you could actually rap. You write your own
yes,
verses?
Sir. Yes, sir.
All those verses you wrote?
Yeah. That was part of my job description.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And they really wanted someone to be able to, you know, contribute to that part of the character. So mm-hmm. As I submitted music to Lee Daniels and Leah Daniels and Senna Homery, who is our music executive, mm-hmm. They liked what I had done either way. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, okay, let's use this song. Let's use this. Let's use that. You know what I mean? And then outside, next to that, a lot of the music was created, you know, based on the script.
Okay. Wow, that's great. Because mm-hmm. there was one scene from one episode that I really enjoyed, and that was The Art of the Battle. Mm. Remember this verse?
Okay. We all know your mommy was a hustler, but you not. You crazy if you think you really touching her, but that's the type of field that I play on. I put that ass in front with no brake on. I blow like I'm napalm, so you should hit the blunt and keep on smoking till your eyes low. Free to spit that ether, boy, the balls will make them die slow. I know you mad cause it's not you, boy, your brother the man, and he put on the nightgown, boy. I'm sorry, boy, you gotta cut the check first. I'll make your neck work, your lady know my best work. This empire all mine, and I ain't got no more time to stand here with all these lies. Which one is it? You want to be the queen or a lion? Tell Cookie get the milk cause the baby keep on crying. This head not my swag. Hey Lucius, please give him a tap. Sweat about to make me mad.
That was dope.
I was like, no.
That was fun.
No, I knew no right, like no playwriter
right.
wrote that verse.
Playwriter.
I'm not gonna play Yaz's verse. But Hakeem, he played Hakeem on the show. He did his verse. Does he write his? Do you know?
I'm honestly not sure.
Okay. I felt like they robbed you. I really feel like they robbed your character. I felt like you won that battle that day.
The thing is that we believe in hip hop.
Yeah.
We believe in that. You know what I'm saying? And I think that was a simple display of two different type of artists. Mm-hmm. You had the lyricist and you had the performer.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Yeah. Even to in today's world, everybody wants to be seen. They want to create a performance. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? It's yeah. not really, you're not getting what KRS gave you in, you know,
mm-hmm. Cops Rakim is Coming. Yeah,
you're not
guys.
You're not really yeah. getting that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So it's just, I think that I didn't look at it as a robbery, uh-huh. even as a consumer. Take mm-hmm. me out of the screen. You know what I'm saying? Even as a consumer, I didn't look at it as a robbery. It's like, yo, she did her thing for what she was able to do, and so did he.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that's how I look at it.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? It was cool with me. That. But our music executive, Senna Homery, she comes from hip hop.
Yeah, she used to direct videos and stuff too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You see how you know so much about my girl like that? Yeah, but I mean, she comes from hip hop. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And when it came down to that scene, because she directed it, and she like Breezy, like, I need that hip hop. Like, I know you can give it to me. Mm-hmm. I need that. That was so important to her. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I tried to bring across.
Wow, you did it.
What
I
made
like
you?
That.
How did you find out about Empire? Like, what made you audition for it? Like, what? Tell us about that. How what that process like?
I actually received a phone call from someone who just recommended me. Mm. Heard that they were auditioning and they were looking for female artists, and he said that, you know, I think you should just try it out. And I'm like, but I ain't no actor, bro.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So he's like, but you rap, it don't matter. You can rap, you got bars, and mm-hmm. they had this girl, that girl, but they ain't mm-hmm. you, Breeze. I'm like, okay, cool. So I sent a few songs and some pictures just so they knew what I looked like. And the next day I met with Leah Daniels, mm-hmm. Who does Lee's casting, and I auditioned. They gave me the script. I went in. I wasn't too comfy with the script part of it because mm-hmm. it was new to me. So I went and I tried my best to not look at the paper, but I was looking at it. So mm-hmm. I left, took a break, and actually went to study it for about an hour, came back, and was able to recite it without the paper. You know what wow. I mean? And at yep. that moment, like Leah and there's a writer named Rada, mm-hmm. and she's actually from Brownsville. Mm-hmm. She was the one who created the character Freda Gatz. And they loved it, you know, just rap form a little bit, and they really liked it. It all worked out.
Wow, that's been congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah. And Lee Breezy. Daniels was just like, you know, I think you're a perfect fit for what I'm trying to do. You know what I'm saying?
You're a natural actor too, actress, because you playing opposite, you know, award winning actors.
Yeah,
you right. know, and you're so smooth and seamless with it that yeah. It's hard to tell that you're even in character, and that's hard. You never acted prior to Empire. Mm-mm.
Like a damn fool.
Breezy's here. Look, I'm going to open up the phone lines, 888-742-3345. I want to take them back, oh. Got them bars, son? Yeah. Let's play it, man. Sweat in the morning. Shade 45. Breezy is here, ladies and gentlemen. Come and see me. I know you. The only one. I shouldn't have fucked you. So what you say was that line?
I shouldn't fuck you like I do. Too. No, I shouldn't trust you like I do.
Yeah. Damn, I've been told that before.
Have you now?
It's a lot with you, Sway.
You know what it is? When I get next to folks like Breezy, who uh-huh. I could tell is 100 with it, I don't have no problem opening up.
You should never.
Right?
Yeah, I always want you to be honest with me.
Yeah, I'm only going to be honest with you. You know,
y'all going to do the same?
Yeah, what about you?
Me?
Yeah.
Always.
Okay. Let me ask you this.
Ask me.
Damn.
Tracy. Let me move up.
Let me get back up off of this.
Don't one. Leave me.
No!
Yeah. Don't leave me.
We a triad here.
Only one.
But Brie, I feel like once your star started rising, the number one question I would see on Twitter is, you know, with the whole art reflecting life, a lot of people assume that Freda is a lesbian, and then that leads them to have their own opinions or thoughts or questions about your sexual orientation. Are you comfortable talking about that?
Yeah.
Cool.
I'm comfortable. I mean, people are going to assume.
Yeah.
They're going to assume I'm a lesbian as well. The way I feel is that if you happen to make it in my bedroom, you'll understand exactly what I am or who I am. Other than that, it's not really up for discussion.
Why?
Yeah, but you're going to have a lot of dudes trying to find their
and
way.
That's fine. That's fine.
Right.
That's fine.
You might have to have two different
but that's
lines
fine. But you understand, like, it's just, you know, it's funny to me because when it comes to a heterosexual relationship mm-hmm. or situation, it's not like, oh, are you fucking girls? Mm-hmm. Like, I'm doing, if you make it.
Mm-hmm. If you make it to the bedroom.
You make it past go and you collect them $200. you gonna understand exactly what's going on. That's why we'll never have to question it. It's not nothing we gotta broadcast though.
Right.
I don't care what you do. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
You got. That's why you got a combine.
Yeah, if they make it to the combine.
You got to make it.
You got to make the team. I mean, season, they tried out. They know every April. You know, I'm all this hard. Exactly. You know, it's hard. I can't appease everybody.
Right.
Listen, let me see what you do.
That's true. And
everybody can't go.
Everybody's
convertible.
Breeze, yeah. That's what I tried to explain to some sisters yesterday. Y'all all up in the house getting dressed. Niggas is wilding. Y'all want to go to the party, the club popping. Y'all right. all could get dressed and be fly.
Right.
We headed to the party, but downstairs, I got a two-seater. Everybody can't
only
go.
Only one of y'all going to get in the car.
The whole concept is everybody
whoever
can
smell the
go.
Best is getting in my car.
Whoever
smells the best is getting in my
whoever
car.
Whoever I fuck with. Is getting in my who I gotta really fuck with you like that.
If I'm driving a two-seater, I honestly don't want nobody to ride with me.
Damn!
That's the hook. So you got your own way of knowing everybody can't go. She right. got her own way. The hook
but
is
I mean, that's
the
just
down.
Realistic. Like, that's just realistic. This is not, two-seater. Come on. We not out here just like with badges on like, yeah, I fuck boys on Tuesdays and Thursdays. Mm-hmm. And on Wednesday and Friday, tell your sister to call me. Mm-hmm.
You know, like, that's what my mom thought about me. I came out to my mom and told her I was bisexual. And she was like, Tracy, please don't tell me that you are selling your pussy on the streets.
Mom, that's not what I said.
That's what she thought.
Mom, I didn't say that.
She thought I had a whole schedule lined up. And I was like, nah, bro, chill. Everything's going to be okay.
But I mean, people make a spectacle of it for no reason.
Yeah.
And it's like, I don't feel the need to say anything because 9 times out of 10, you're not going to make it to the bedroom.
You're not going to make it to the bedroom. Plus, if you go
there.
You go in Breezy's bedroom, you probably see drum machines and computers. And
it's all work, no play in my house.
Yeah, you
for real, that's to be honest.
You don't
want
to be in the bedroom. There ain't no space to stand.
She's spooning that's, with her MacTub.
But what?
Your Mac, your laptop.
Your laptop. MacBook. Your
right.
MacBook, yeah.
My favorite thing in the world. But to be honest with y'all, like, I'm in such a work mode right now. So mm-hmm. there is no dating. There is no talking to nobody. There is no sex. There's none of that. I got to stay focused. I'm like a boxer when it comes to this shit. I got to do what I got to do.
I like that.
You know what I'm saying? So that's how I discipline myself. You know what I'm saying? I'm not falling weak for anything. Not no woman, not no man. I'm not. Not right now. I need 50 million by 2017.
Come on.
Then we could talk about
love. Yeah, yeah.
Hey, we could talk about
if
it.
If you get that 50 million, I'm coming to work for you.
That's fine.
All right.
No sex. But, no sex in the champagne room.
Now, you produced that song?
No, I didn't produce it, but okay. I do write and record and mix my music.
You mix your own music.
Mm-hmm.
So what's the future for your music? Because you're on the show, and then those songs that you do for the show belong to the show, right?
Yeah. And, okay. and honestly, with the exception of like one or two, most of them are tailor made for that character. So mm-hmm. I don't feel like anything was taken from me. Mm-hmm. You know, like I said, that was my job. I did what I had to do for the character. Mm-hmm. So when it comes to Breezy the artist, I'm just trying to at this point create that separation between Freda Getz and Breezy. And as you just heard on Come and See Me, and that's actually a Drake and Party Next Door record. But you know, I have different styles of music, so I would like to just, you know, get out there, use the platform, show the versatility within myself, you know, and hopefully people like it. I think they will.
That's interesting because Jussie
Smollett
has, you know, last week when he performed with the band?
Yes, love that song. Good Enough.
Good Enough. And I immediately hit him and said, well, shit, I want to hear this from you.
Yeah, let me tell you something. I was actually sitting there on set as he performed that record.
Mm-hmm.
And that song gave me chills. Like, I felt like it gave me D'Angelo.
Yeah.
You know, Maxwell, like, that was such a good record for him. Like,
yeah,
he's dope. I was begging Senna, I'm begging everybody for that song. And they're like, no. I was like, can I please have it?
Yeah.
And we shot it, like, months ago. It's like, can I please have it?
Mm-hmm.
Such a good record.
But he as well as Yaz, it seemed like all artists are going to have not even a struggle, but that job to do to separate yourself from the character. Mm-hmm. It's not always so easy, but I think it's going to be easier for you because I don't, you could see it when you walked in on it, it was like, nah, she's an MC playing a rapper on Empire.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
I don't think you're going to have too many issues with that acceptance.
Hopefully not.
Yeah.
Hopefully not. But I think it's a matter of how much, you know, hard work and dedication you're willing to put into what exactly is in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So you can do, you can act and go to acting classes and you can put the music under here. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's just like, what do you want to do? And me, I'm trying to give them both equally.
Nice.
A share shot. I mean, a fair shot. You know what I mean?
Can you cook though? Like,
can I?
What's your baked chicken? The baked chicken? You hear that, HB?
I'm always baking chicken.
You're a baked chicken?
I love to cook. I love to cook, and I'm on the road so much and eating out, and I don't eat that much. Like, you know, so when I get home, I love to cook.
Okay. Black woman that cooks chicken. That's a rarity.
Shut up. Don't you eat
whatever.
There.
I mean, I can honestly make whatever. I just love, you know, you trying to watch out for this figure.
Yeah.
Fast.
You gotta, you know, gotta.
Try to keep it tight.
Yo, crop top
out there.
That's what I'm saying. Ain't nobody gonna want to come play in my room if I'm. I start swelling up.
How has your life changed though, sis? Like, are you still living in the same home or? Yeah. You ain't bought nothing or?
Nope.
Good.
New
you
socks.
Saving your money?
Yeah, I'm chilling.
Yeah,
I'm chilling. My happiness comes from just being able to, you know, provide for the people around me. You know, and you know that, but I just try to keep it as simple and plain as possible.
Yeah. I'm already, you know. I've liked you before you walked in the room. Like, I feel like, you know, like we were already connected, being that we both, you know, co-starred on Empire before. It just, you know.
It's a lot.
We got King on the line from Detroit. What up, King?
King,
what's popping?
What's up, though?
What up? Say hello to Breezy.
What's up, Breezy? I had a role with you. We drove all the way to Texas. I'm from Detroit. With B&B.
With B&B.
Yeah. She used to perform, and I remember she used to give out red bottoms.
Red bottoms every show.
You're right,
King. Shout out to you.
Who's giving out red bottoms?
I had a record called Red Bottom My Bitch, and it was real, real heavy in Detroit. It was a time where I was in Detroit with Charlie Baltimore and B&B Records, and I was out there for at least probably 2.5 years, just flooding the city heavy. Uh-huh. Like, Detroit showed me so much love, and he right. We drove 22 hours from Detroit to Texas. For South by Southwest, and I went to South by Southwest, probably hit about 8-9 stages, and we was giving red bottoms out every show.
Real red bottoms?
Right.
Absolutely real. We was at Bloomies and Saks Fifth, me and Peanut, every morning, like, yo, which ones we getting today? We gonna get the new pumps, the black pumps. It was nice. The girls loved it.
She said, yeah, there's nothing, Sway. It's nothing. She just nodded like, yeah.
But I mean, you know, everybody has their own marketing and ways they want to, you know, promote records or whatever. And that's how we chose to do it. Peanut was like, yo, Breeze, you might as well just do some crazy shit. Just give out a pair of red bottoms a show. I'm like, bro, you really want to spend $1,200? You really want to spend $1,200 a show?
Yeah, that's how much they cost,
Tracy,
right?
She said she wear size 9.
And he was good. I mean, you know, Pino's a good dude, man. Yeah. Pino's a good dude. Yeah. Got an independent label called B&B Records. Him and Charlie Baltimore, and they showed me a lot of love.
That's what's up.
A lot of love.
Charlie's a friend of the show. Yeah. She's a citizen. We got...
Shout out to King. I appreciate that, bro.
We got Shagrin on the line from Ohio. What up?
Shaggy.
It's Chagrin.
Okay, my bad.
I'm sorry, Sway. I ain't trying to.
I felt a little energy right there.
I got
my team with me though.
Chagrin.
I got Breezy here. Don't step to me.
My bad, boy. Okay. I don't want them problems.
Okay.
Good. I don't want them problems.
That's what's up, yo.
I don't want them problems. You know. I had that problem all my life. I be having to correct people. You know.
Okay, Chagrin, right?
Yep.
To my chagrin, you're on the line. All right, go ahead.
Don't do me.
Would you ask your question, though?
I really didn't have no questions. I just wanted to, you know, let her know I'm a big fan of you, Breezy. I fuck with you.
Thank you. I fuck with you back.
And after, you know, after listening to your interview and shit like that and finding out that you write your own rap off the show. That shit is so dope to me because I be really sitting there like, she be spitting. Like,
that's
you
nice.
Know what I'm saying? Sitting there watching the show. That shit is, that's what's up. And sitting here listening to how humble you is. That is so, I just love you.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
I just love you. Oh my God.
I love you too.
Okay. Follow her on social media at
Breezy Official. B-R-E-Z Official.
Okay. Chagrin. You're a citizen.
I already do.
Thanks for calling, bro.
That's what's up. You're a citizen. I know.
She's
going for those red bottoms, boy. She's trying hard. That was a long time ago.
Real nice.
All right.
Shout out to King. That is crazy. crazy.
Yeah, King.
That was a crazy trip to Texas.
King had facts, too.
Yeah.
He had facts.
Had the history on him.
He didn't even try to prove it. He was like, you know, we rolled from Texas to Detroit to Texas.
Sway, we was like six
hungry.
Cars deep.
But you got to pay those dudes. Deep.
And let me tell you what was the craziest part. Niggas was on the road acting like they was tired. And they was drunk and they couldn't drive, you know. So I really hit like 15 hours on the road, like solo in a pickup truck.
Oh, you
driving?
Yeah. But see, those
because
things,
it's like I'm not putting my life in nobody else's hands. Y'all keep bitching, cool. But I'm not going. You know, I was mad, but I'm like, I'm gonna get there because I'm not gonna swerve off and die messing with one of y'all.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But we did. It was a real good time.
Yeah, you present.
And they just, they fueled me. They fueled me. I got the South by Southwest and tried to fuck every stage up. I was so mad. I drove so.
What year was that?
This was probably like three years ago.
Been putting in work.
Yeah. Probably like 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, this was right when Boosie was coming home.
Uh-huh.
Because it was a whole army of people in the street with Boosie's head, like on the poster. The stick.
Right.
You know the stick.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And I'm like, damn, like, but Boosie was there, but he wasn't there.
Yeah. His aura.
He was there in spirit. Breezy. This has been quite enjoyable for us.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I hope you enjoyed yourself here too.
I did.
Yeah. It ain't over though.
Nope.
I don't know if you know about the show, but this is that show. You could rap for anybody, any show you want to in the world, ladies and gentlemen. But until you come to Sway in the Morning to the Valley of the Hyenas. To the Valley of the Hyenas. To the Valley of the Hyenas. It really don't count. DJ wanted to drop a beat on him.
Sway, I've been waiting on these moments.
Ooh, let's get it. Breezy, Sway in the Morning.
Breeze.
Let's go.
I ain't never need not one nigga you can ask around. It was all me. Y'all bitches never had none for me, and I put that there on a thing. When it come down to this rap shit, they don't wanna see me. I trash niggas. I don't care who you sign with. I still put you in a bag, nigga. That chain got you feeling bad, bitch. Like a bitch who ain't had shit. That Instagram got you fucked up. I can't do nothing but laugh, bitch. We gon' end it here. Y'all sit back and watch me do it. Now I don't know who your writer is, but I swear to God that he booty. See, I talk shit that I want. Bet I live the shit that I spit. A hater really can't tell me nothing unless he did the shit that I did. I ain't gonna talk about how them guns blend. We all know that them guns jam. When that heat out and them moose swings, your shooter turned to Hussein. He an actor nigga, not a rapper nigga. He the phony type that never had a nigga. But you ain't gotta lie, nigga. Everybody ain't try to die, nigga. I'm the same, I just grew up. Took a mean flow when I blew up. These niggas know I go way back like that 62 on that Maybach. Got a small mouth, I been talking shit since a nigga told me they hated that. Never gave a fuck, I got my haters up. With a bad bitch who never ate it up. Never mind, I'm here, nigga. No, they don't like me like Hilfiger. I'm a real bitch, I do real shit. I can't see you, you frail, nigga. You a lame boy, so game boy. Never heard of you, you know the name, boy. You can't blame me, cause you the same nigga. You're suicide on your fame, nigga. Who is Breezy? You ain't heard. I'm gunning for the top, nigga. Coming hard, you know I need that number one spot. I'm in the kitchen now, I'm whipping, sweating on the pot. My body itching like I'm fiending, but I'm really not. Sway.
Real MC up in here.
Word.
What it look like?
Real MC up in here.
Facts. No printer.
I ain't said in a while, but you whack motherfuckers. You see why I hate you?
Facts, no printer.
You can't
facts,
do what
no
she
printer.
Do.
No printer.
No printer.
Facts, no printer.
Sweat.
Ain't make no excuses.
No excuses. Jump right on top of the track.
Pretty
no
much.
Printed it.
I ain't gonna
conviction.
Lie. I ain't gonna lie, so I've been waiting on moments like this.
Yeah, I've been
these
waiting on
these are the
you.
Moments I've been waiting
yeah,
on.
Yeah,
these moments.
Let me tell you something. When I first saw you come on that show, I said, we're gonna get on our show. We're gonna get on this show because, for number one, your passion and your dedication to the culture is I appreciate it most. You know, I like listening to folks because, you know, we're inspired by the same things.
Right.
I may have been in it longer, but you inspire me.
Right.
Because I could tell you care about this. Like what you were saying, it's a difference between a performer and an MC.
Right.
You an MC.
Right.
So I could feel that. And what you're going to continue to do by being that is you're going to continue to raise the bar.
Yeah.
That's what this show is all about, raising the bar. We don't give a fuck who they run with,
yeah.
How much money they made.
You're right.
We don't
I just
care
feel
about
like it's a bigger purpose to it.
Absolutely.
It's a bigger purpose. And I feel like to, you know, to be given a platform is a gift from God. You know what I'm saying? And you
Amen.
Gotta be able to, the most important thing for me is that there's so many people watching me. So I'm mindful of what I'm saying. Mm. I'm mindful of what I'm putting in this music. You know what I'm saying? Because music controls the minds at the end of the day. So I got to be able to provide in that way, you know, for my people. You know what I'm saying? So that's really, that's why I take my time. And I have been doing it a long time.
Yeah.
But I take my time because it's got to be right.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
I don't want to encourage the wrong things. I don't want to persuade the wrong type of people. You know what I'm saying? I want, it's got to make sense because I know it's a purpose.
Wow.
That's beautiful.
Breezy, ladies and gentlemen. I love you for that, yo. You're giving me chills right now. Shit.
Goes right with the theme of today.
Until that new music come. We got, you got a home right here, Breezy. You officially, you part of the family. You ain't just a citizen. You a family member. Hit her up.
We cousins.
Family.
Cousins. Member, cousins, all right? You know what? We do this thing called the Doomsday Cipher.
That's dope.
And it's a pretty big deal for us, you know, and a lot of talented people like King Los, P, Oswin Benjamin, Nick Grant, you know, K Shine, Murder Mook, Lantana, Chris Rivers,
3D Not T.
I said, Kelly, I appreciate
that's
that.
That's a heavy lineup.
That's a heavy lineup.
And
that's the caliber. You see the caliber I'm talking? So when we do the next one, I want to officially invite you to be a part of that next one.
I'm there.
Doomsday Cypher.
Miss Diddy, we there.
And that's going to be, well, that's in December, so you
don't
might
matter.
Get, okay, cool.
All right.
Mark it.
And then did we, Token, are we going to get Token on there too?
Oh my gosh. Oh. Token.
Army Regime, Spitters, you'll love it.
Why we ain't have we? What's his name? Fred the Godson never did it.
Fred's done
the Doomsday.
Not the Doomsday. We get Fred.
So is that here? Is that here in New York?
It's in New York.
Okay,
but we never know. We might bring it to Miss Diddy. Might hook something up for us in
LA. Let's go to Miami
or
Puerto Rico. You know,
the only thing I'm thinking about December, you know, it's going to be cold as hell.
Puerto Rico ain't cold. So,
yeah.
We can bring it to LA.
Come on, Heather.
International.
I'm just saying, man, that's just my pocket, though.
Huh?
I got to bring everybody to Puerto Rico?
You got a budget.
Well, we got to work something out.
We got to work something out. All right.
Wow,
Breezy, congratulations.
Thank you so
much. Continue success.
Thank you so much.
All right,
I appreciate it.
Don't change nothing about you. You good for the game, okay?
Yes,
that's
sir.
Breezy. Make sure y'all reach out to her. Once again, get your social media.
Yeah, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, at Breezy Official, B-R-E-Z Official.
Akon was hanging out with my family the other day.
SoundCloud.com/Breezy Official.
Breezy Official. Hit her up. The truth. Citizens, hit her up anyway. Let her know what you think of her, man. She's the truth. Akon sent me a world premiere.
Oh, word?
Yeah.
And, shout out Khan.
Yeah, Akon, man. That dude is the truth, too. And saw him flipping fans off the stage. I mean, them days he was lifting up. Anyway, so we're going to play that Akon World Premiere up next. It's Sway in the Morning, Shade 45.
Yeah.
It's Sway in the Morning, only
on Shade 45.